Here we are, the Greenwood Car Show. We see lots of cars and lots of people. Got a Ford truck that looks doesn't look all that vintage to me, but then I'm old. Here's a Volkswagen Karmann Ghia. And a little GTI. But now we got some classic Beetles. Lots of Beetlemania here. Do not touch, okay? I won't. See? I won't touch. Beetle with the front trunk. Lots of Beetles.
Oh, I went through any different.
This is a Volkswagen Rogue. Oh, I like that little decoration right there, kind of a hidden Aztec dragon. This one, it's a work in progress. Here's a bright orange convertible. And a little microbus. We got some microbuses. We see lots of happy people having a great time. Sun is shining. Shining bright. What do we got over here? What do we got on this side? I don't know what the heck that is, but it sure is pretty. This looks like a Chevy. It has a flathead look, but that doesn't mean that's what it is. And we got the Thunderbird. It's a classic Thunderbird with an 8-cylinder motor in there. A little pony car that goes fast. And then over here, more of a Camaro. Well, not really a Camaro, AMC kind of thing. Let's go across the 83rd Street. And we see an SS, couple of them, Chevrolet vehicles. A Camaro SS, probably named for Camaro Avenue in Southern California. 6.2 liter. What the hell is that in cubic inches? We know it's a bunch of them. And this SS El Camino. I guess 396 is what 6.1 liters is in American. It says 396. So we'll take their word for it. It's a 396. And here's a work in progress truck. When you look at vintage cars, classic cars, the advice is to check for rust, check for rust, check for rust. Yep, there's rust all right. Yes siree, we got some rust there. And this looks like a 57. Look at those little pointy things on the hood of the 57. Very pretty. Very, very pretty restoration. Lots of bright orange and everything. The twin antennas. And we got a Bel Air station wagon up here. Lots of very pretty cars here. And some ugly ones. I like that Corvette. Another Bel Air convertible. Looks like a 56 over there. But this is a very pretty Corvette. Look at this nice sky blue, turquoise blue look. 55, not a 56. Okay, I stand corrected. Maybe this one's a 56. Slightly different shape hood ornament.
The driver's side in your fender.
You know, the neat thing about the hood ornaments, they make you think of a fast jet aircraft.
Am I on my dad's car?
Oh, I like that purple job. When you restore an ancient car, you might as well get creative in colors and paint schemes. There's the engine back there. Probably a 283. Well, it would be if it was original. Of course, when they're this old, you never know if they're original. There's a 56 machine. It's got, I don't know what kind of screen that is. Another one. Lots of blowers there. That way, for the 1% of the time you actually need it, you can move forward in a hurry. Most time, of course, you're not using all that horsepower. Oh, I like the air cleaner on that. That's kind of pretty. We got the Chevys on this. Well, these cars look 40-ish. 1940-ish. What do we got over here? 1941, whatever the heck that is. Look at the weird air cleaner on top of that. A little deuce coupe. Oh my gosh. This looks like the Bonnie and Clyde car. Not quite Bonnie and Clyde car. They didn't go for pickups when they stole their Ford V8 to use in their saying V8, probably got the old flathead.
As opposed to a five-window coupe, is the door the same?
I don't think so. I think the two-door door is longer.
Yeah, here's the flathead. Valves in the cylinder block, not on top. Look at all those pretty nuts holding the top on. Holding the heads on.
Hey, that was good sound.
Yeah.
Thank you. 1949. A more recent Ford. Highest compression engine in any farm truck. Willie's Hurricane. Willie's the people that made the Jeep. Speaking of Willys, here's a Jeep, 1943 Jeep. Holy smokes. 1930.
A Willys, I mean a Jeep, whatever you call it.
That's a Willys Jeep. Three cubic inch flathead cylinder.
Look at this. A 46.
And somebody got a nice 72 vehicle. Dodge with the 340. That's plenty big enough for a car that size. Well, let's keep on going down this way. Oh, check that out. Look at the motor. For sale, 6,500. Yeah, nothing like a flat black primer and a rusty engine that says 6,500. Let's part with it right now. Although you'll need more than that to buy one of these pretty Chevys. With 2 million, you could probably buy a bunch of these vehicles and a garage to store them in and a mechanic to maintain them. You can hire him too.
Yeah,
Ford Deluxe. Start looking like the 40s cars. What the heck? How do you lower the hood over that?
That's got a little fuel injection in it.
Yeah. Hey, Merc. A little jet airplane hood ornament. And what we got here? Next to the Mustang and Audi. Couple of Mustangs, 302.
But it's got a Corvette motor in it.
Yeah. If that car Corvette. Had a BMW with a Corvette? Are you kidding me? A 350 cubic inch Corvette engine in a BMW? Okay. If you can fit it.
It's a Mustang.
Fit it perfect. It's only 50 pounds heavier than the original block.
Probably. Oppo. A Nova with a 350. Huh, got a breather cap. I didn't know they had breather caps as late as 1971. We got pretty girls. We got all kinds of good people. And somebody.
Appreciate you. Check it out.
Yeah, I'm not interested. Thanks anyway. What do we got here?
Oh, yeah. Well, that
more pretty cars.
I'm telling you.
Ford's on the right. GM products here. And Avante.
Hello.
Lots of Avantes. Sale. 8,900. You two can have a Thunderbird.
Yeah. Yeah, 8,900 on sale.
Huh?
8,900 for sale.
Mustang. Dodge Coronet. '58 Coronet. Almost like the Plymouth that used in the used in the Christine movie. Car that had a mind of its own. An evil mind of its own. There's this Fury 3.
Do you want me to go home?
Used to use these for cop cars. And a big New Yorker. Look at that New Yorker. Cruising in the New Yorker. See all that? A 1961 New Yorker. Who's got the push button transmission? Yep, it looks like it. Yep, push button transmission. Car, you look at, how the heck do I shift the gears in this thing? And we got a boat car, an amphibious assault vehicle. Look at the propellers underneath. And a DeSoto, which I believe was a Chrysler Corporation kind of thing.
See that record player?
MD Pace car.
So if you look around the back side of that color, Chrysler and New Yorkers?
1970.
Oh, the people. I have no idea what the heck it is, but it looks like 1930-ish.
Yeah. Simple.
Challenger. Chrysler Imperial, that's what this is. We got this big old Challenger.
Lee! Look for the big W.
Now there's a New Yorker. Big, long New Yorker. Well, look at that hood. It looks like an inline V8. Inline 8.
It's a straight 8.
Straight 8. Got a straight 8 in this motor, in this machine. Look at all this.
Yeah, you're not opening it up.
Look at what we got here. The Silvio, whatever this. Another Beetle. Lots of Beetlemania. A Volvo. Oh. Little Deuce Coupe here. With four carburetors? That's just a little too much, you ask me. An interesting blower on the front of that. Retro rods. A Shelby. Air cleaner over two carburetors. I think that's what that is. Why do you need two carburetors? But some people like to be able to move forward. So 1% of the time you have occasion to put that pedal down. Well, looks like we can cross 80 pits. Well, they're letting the cars through. Whistle, and across the street we go. Well, smile, you're on candid camera. Got the Haggerty Bruce. Tweet, tweet. A replica track roadster.
Every place here. Yep. I mean, I don't care. But,
'1939 Ford Deluxe. There's three little carburetors on top of that flathead.
I like this one.
flathead V8 that Bonnie and Clyde wrote a letter to Ford Motor Company praising. Displacement badge crew. That would be an awful lot of bore on those cylinders to get up to 461. But maybe that's that is what's in there. Gene 37 Oldsmobile. Amazing how many flathead V8s there are here. Yeah, here's the O'Reilly. A Futura. A Futura that is still alive in the future. .302, according to that. A Futura alive in the future. The future is now, 2019. .1952 Bel Air. We're gonna put over the what that was for. Is that a GTO? I'm looking two GTOs or Le Mans's maybe. Let's see. Looks like 66, 67. That looks like a 67. Oh boy, they fancied up the motor. Well, it says 66. I thought that was 67 from the looks of it. Got the convertible. Bucket seats. Lid, everything. GTO type rear end. That looks like a Le Mans style rear end on this one. Tempest. Tempest in a teacup. Looks like the automatic transmission on the floor. Shift in between the buckets. I don't know why they put a scoop hood there, but it's there. Eight-cylinder motor, though. Wonder if that's 326 or 389. Could be either. Or 421. It could be. They can throw anything in these. Breather cap on one side, non-breather cap on the other. Four barrel. And we got a Viper V10. Listening to some AC/DC. the kind of Corvette you can re-enter the atmosphere with. Some heavy metal here. $7, real popular. '64 Chevy. '39 Pontiac Coupe. Oh, wow. An old Pontiac. And, of course, we have the Trans Am with the Screaming Eagle on the hood. 6.6 is actually 400. I don't know why they call it 6.6. 400 works. T-roof. Holy smokes. Like Nancy Drew can drive this on one of her adventures. Kind of a contrast to the 39 Pontiac. We got Camaros. The doors are coming up weird.
I rock, I rock.
Dodge Viper. If you're stinking rich, you can buy one of these. Yeah, Isuzu Impulse. Please do not touch. Okay, I won't. Cadillac, whatever the heck that is. Cadillacs don't look like they're vintage. I think we will go across the street because I see a red goat. A red GTO. Shall we take this red, take a looky peekable at this red GTO? I think we should. Across the street. What do we got here? GTO badges. Two four-barrel carburetors on top. That is a bit much, you think, but that was the selling point of the GOAT. You put the pedal down in lowest gear and she moves forward. Got manual brakes, not power brakes. So when you're downhill, you're holding the 3,500 pounds of car with your leg. Bucket seats. The shifter on the center console looks like a manual shift. Four on the floor. So you have to know how to do that. And the classic GTO rear end that distinguishes from Le Mans's and Tempest. Yeah, this work in progress truck. And we got this pretty restored truck. Texaco, holy moly. Boy, the engine sure looked different back in the day. That's Ford. Old bumper. The same sort of vehicle, 1920 Model A, but they got a lot prettier.
Cool camera, what's that?
It's a This is a GoPro.
Oh, is it?
Yeah. Thunderbird. In the fair lane. Whoopsie dee. The Willis Jeep. Nice big old Willis Jeep. Another Ford, real pretty. Mustang with the 289. We got a Mustang. It'll get you there in a hurry. Well, they are probably wise to hold within the speed limit.
Recent running gear in it.
A mini fleet. Oh wow. Got a mini engine in the mini fleet. Probably owned by a lady named Mini Cooper. Or not. Little Mercedes. Car company named for some guy's daughter. Hey, Plymouth. 383, that's fast enough. '97 Ford Mustang. Yeah, whatever. Another little Mustang. A Stingray. Huh? Yeah. Interesting little blower. And your last ride. When you go out in style. You gotta leave this world, leave it in style. On your way to the crematorium. What the heck is that? I mean, Tesla's got the right idea. It's a lot easier to sell an electric car if it's not a little dork mobile. We seem to have our electric mobiles here. Frankly, I'm more interested in the internal combustion engines. Let's feed the plants with that carbon dioxide. Trains in. With a little scoop on top. And, of course, it's got the rather loud screaming eagle on the top.
Oh, yeah, it does. Let's go, Reed. Look.
It's got the screaming eagle on top. Go up to this Impala. Big old car. Says 327 on the side. Might be a 327 inside if it says 327 on the fender. Mustangs. 68 Mustang. 390 on under the hood. The Shelby GTS with the turntable squirting. You're gonna drive me a drinking if you don't stop driving that hot rod Lincoln. Look at that Lincoln. Size of the motor under the hood. 65 Lincoln. And a couple of little kids in there. I didn't see those. Very pretty car. Convertible too. A T-Bird right next to it.
1972 Chevelle built for 72 Chevelle convertible that was plotted.
Classic 50s T-Bird. '56 T-Bird. '428. I think that's enough displacement for a little car like that. Think it'll be gutless?
69.
Should be able to climb all the way up Snoqualmie Pass to 65, you think?
Yeah.
Without even breathing hard. A Boss V02. And a Mustang. Seems to have a lot of Mustangs here. Little Chevrolet. I think it's a 58. It looks 58-ish. Back when they made cars into castles on wheels. Truck, all pretty. Imperial.
What?
It's amazing.
A good vehicle for the Imperial Troopers. I see this car right here every once in a while. Even got the little turntable thing on top of the motor. Of course, kind of have to remove that when they drive it away, but it does look like a very pretty thing.
Yeah, that's pretty.
And like a little hummingbird toy. That's pretty cool. Let's head back the other way. Maybe we still have some juice in this battery. That's one thing about GoPros. The batteries do tend to wear out, tend to last about an hour or not even that much.
Huh?
And bring my spare batteries to switch out. Lots of Mustang and Mustangish cars on this side of the street. I think these are electric motors. Yep, they're electric motors.
We got this one.
For whom we installed the charger.
Where's that wrap for
oh. Save oil, burn coal.
Oh my God.
I'm electric. I run on coal and uranium. Maybe with the frack and some methane gas. If you want to believe it's falling water, we'll let you believe that. But I still prefer these gasoline burners. Okay, I'm gonna show off.